together with grammar, with, yeah, like a conjugation and so on, you call that. O und U. Aber hier, das ist leicht. Sag nochmal, Maria. Das hier ist? Ist leicht. It's easy. Ist ziemlich leicht. Das hier habt ihr noch nicht richtig gesagt. You haven't spoken that correctly yet. Nee. Ja, hier. Yeah, it's getting close. Yes. Ö. No. Ö. 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 Das ist gut, ja. Ö. Nee, nicht U. Ö. Ö. Und Emanuel?
Ö.
Richtig? Und? Wie heißt du
noch? Ö.
Ö.
Das
ist ein bisschen schwer.
Yeah.
It's a little difficult.
Yeah.
Ö. That's why I think.
Ö.
Schwer. Schwer. In German, the word schwer is the same as heavy or hard. Schwer. Es ist ein bisschen schwer. It is a little difficult. That's why I thought we should practice that when we had the alphabet, but also we have to learn the correct pronunciation. If you don't get the correct pronunciation, maybe people will misunderstand you. That's exactly, that's why it's important. E, easy. Everybody can say E. You say E, 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 open mouth.
E.
Yeah, always E. Hey, you say that so. Hey, come here. Hey, something like that. That's A. And then we have here, it's just more difficult. Round your mouth like you want to kiss somebody. Don't we end on dieses here? This is wie?
Was das?
I don't believe that anybody gets it right here. Yeah. Let's see. Hey, what?
I don't know.
Gehst du telefonieren, ja? For instance, we have the number.
So the first one is and then U.
U is easy, ja? U. U.
And this is U. O.
Nee, O ist das hier.
O. O.
Das hier ist Ö.
U. Like you want to be
special. Ö. Das hier nochmal?
Oh.
Nee, gar nicht. Nobody will understand you. You will practice that. You will learn it. That's why you're here, to learn.
Yes.
Huh? Ich meine, wie hast du diesen Buchstaben? Say, for instance, you, wenn man zählt, we want to do the counting also. Eins, zwei, drei, vier, richtig? And then kommt nicht E. You speak an E instead of this here. That's exactly. It's got the letter in it. Here, eins, eins, eins. Right. Eins, das kann man sagen. Zwei, ja. Zwei, ja. Kennt ihr schon die Zahl? Drei, drei, vier. Und jetzt kommt dieses hier. Nee, neither you nor you are right. That's because here you have this Ü in it.
Fünf.
You speak it so that Germans will understand it, but it's not Fünf. When you say Fünf, it sounds like there's an I and an E in it. Yeah. You speak this. But it is, doesn't exist. It's an Ü. The Ü is actually very important. Ü, fünf, 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 fünf. Fünf, sag mal.
Fünf.
Gut, fünf. Maria, nochmal.
Fünf.
Nicht fünf, fünf, Ü.
Fünf.
More out, like a pig. Fünf.
Fünf.
Yeah, it's when you learn a language, sometimes you feel awkward, am I, you know, but it's correct, and fünf, it's better, you know, it's better. Emanuel, say fünf. Fünf. Yeah? Fünf. Gut, yeah, fünf.
So
you learn that.
And
fünf. Und fünf, the Ü ist is the typical letter that's very difficult for you. I know that. Fünf, fünf. And now I tell you what, I invented a little difficult sentence. Fünf, grüne, grüne, green. Grüne. Five green chickens. In German is fünf grüne Hühner, chickens. And you have, in every word, you have Ü. Fünf grüne Hühner. Fünf grüne Hühner.
Grüne.
Ja, grüne is green. Here, your coat is green. Dein Mantel ist grün.
Grüne.
Ja, gut. Ja, just practice a little. Fünf grüne Hühner. The umlaut U is Ü, is sometimes a little longer. Fünf is kurz. Here it's short. Short. Fünf. Grüne is longer. Grüne. And here it is long too. Hühner. Five green chickens.
Misspell of the umlaut?
Umlaut, ja.
Word, say
a
example of
a
word.
This is an example.
For this.
Ö, ah, Ö.
Umlaut.
O umlaut, richtig. O umlaut hatten wir doch. Let's say the word böse. Böse. In the Lord's Prayer, we have one thing: keep us from evil. Evil in German is böse. Keep us from böse Dinge. No, Lord, keep us away from doing bad things. Böse. Böse. Say böse.
Böse.
Böse. You want
it? So it's B, right?
Yeah, B. B, Ö, S, E. Böse. 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 Maria, sag mal böse. Böse. The umlauts are very difficult. Böse. Yeah, good. It's correct. Böse. There are lots of words with Ö also, but it's good to know. Böse. Ä is no problem. There we can say Käse. Cheese. Käse. When you go shopping, you want to buy some cheese, you say, ich möchte Käse. Ich möchte Käse. Käse. I would like to buy some cheese. Käse. Böse. But the biggest problem is the Ü. Ja. Käse. Fünf grüne Hühner. Hier. Ja, grüne Hühner. You must always repeat and try to. Fünf grüne Hühner.
Fünf grüne Hühner.
Ja, every German will understand that now. That's good. Maria, sag mal, fünf grüne Hühner. Fünf grüne Hühner. Five green chickens. Fünf grüne Hühner. Maria? Fünf grüne Hühner, das ist es.
Fünf grüne Hühner.
Hühner. The H here, das H, makes it a little long. It's Hühner. Richtig, ja. Okay. See, there are different, the umlaut U has a different quality here. Fünf, she can substitute the Ü by I, by saying E. Fünf. We understand it, but it's not good. Fünf. Ü. It's short. Grüne is a long Ü. Grüne. And there you can't say grüne. It's not possible. Here, fünf, you can say fünf. Yeah, aber here, you say Ühne. Grüne, Hühner. It comes out correctly. Emmanuel, sag mal, fünf grüne Hühner.
Fünf grüne Hühner.
Das ist gut. Ja, und du?
Hühner.
Hühner. Hühner. Hühner. So you have learned a word too.
Let's complete one.
Yeah. Ach ja, die schweren, the difficult letters. Das ist the difficult letters.
Okay.
Das hier ist, wie ist das?
R.
Difficult to pronounce too, because we got somewhere. R. R. It's like gargling. Like gargling. It's very hard. R. Dann haben wir das Y, okay. Das, you can remember that. But the pronunciation of this letter is difficult. Here is just the name of that letter that makes it difficult because it's different from English. Y, why? Wir haben in English J und hier ist in Deutsch J, richtig? Which other letters are very difficult for you?
I remember V and E.
Richtig. Wenn wir im Deutschen sagen, dieses ist ein hier. D, R, E, I. Ja, E sounds like A in English, but it is E. It's really confusing. E is schwer und I is schwer. I. Ja, schwer to confuse. Und dann haben wir noch einen Buchstaben, der schwierig ist. Und diesen Buchstaben hier ist dann
A.
A. Ja, and it sounds like the R in English. That's why it's really confusing to learn the alphabet. Do you remember the alphabet as the whole? Maria, kannst du das Alphabet aufsagen?
Mm-hmm.
Can you say the alphabet, the German alphabet?
A, B, C, D.
E. Richtig, E. A, B, C, D, E. The next letter is like English. That's easy.
F.
Try to do it by memory.
It's like you can say them in English, but like pronounce or reciting them in Deutsch.
Yeah.
Unless you see them.
Then yeah.
Yeah. Easy. Oh, yeah. When man sie sieht. Yeah, yeah.
B C D A F G H.
Ha.
Ha.
Y
J K K. L, M, N, O, P.
No, not P, P.
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 P. Q, L.
Yeah, Q is English, our Deutsch is similar. Q, yeah.
R.
Yeah, L is like English. L.
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 S.
No? Wie ist der nächste? M.
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 M. No, after M comes the letter.
Okay. M. N. O. P.
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 Who has the? You said it already.
Who?
Yeah.
R.
R is English.
L.
R. S, ja.
T.
T.
U.
Ja, 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 ja. V.
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 V. V. Richtig. Und? Und das W ist dann?
V.
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 V. X. X, richtig.
Ups.
Y, ja.
Z.
Z. Z. Z. Z. Z. Z. Ja, gut, einigermaßen. You can still learn a little better, but it's the basis is there. It's very good. Yeah, you can then really work from that. But try not to forget. Some letters are very difficult. Can you say the whole alphabet again?
A. B. C. D. E.
Richtig.
F. Ga, ge.
Ge.
Ge. H.
Nee, H ist Englisch.
Ha.
Ha, richtig.
I.
Ja.
J.
Richtig, J.
T.
K. Nee, K, ja.
K. L. M. N. U. P. U. L. S. T.
T.
T. U. Fab.
Richtig.
W. X.
Nee, X ist Englisch. Im Deutschen ist similar.
X.
Nicht X, sondern X.
X. Upsilon.
Gut. Insgesamt. Quite okay. Ja, machst du das auch nochmal? A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
A, B, C, D.
Nee.
D, D. E, F. D, H. I. Jetzt.
Nee, J.
J. J. A. L. M. N. O. P. Q. L. S. T.
T.
T. U. P. V.
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 V. V. Ja.
Yeah. X.
Nee.
X.
X. Nee.
X.
X. X. So. X. Ja, richtig.
Upsilon.
Ja.
Z.
Ja. Gut. Dann haben wir noch Ä, Ö, Ü. Das kommt aber dann noch. We will do that.
S.
Ah, that's a German letter that no other language has. It's not part of the alphabet, actually. They call it SZ, as you said, this here. It's a funny letter. Actually, it exists only in small letter, as a small letter. We don't have big letter for that. It is only done in Germany. Other language, other countries, in Switzerland or Austria, they don't have that. We have that. But it is... When you write a word with SZ, zum Beispiel outside is called au, and then we have this funny letter, the SZ, SZ, and it means außen.
Außen.
And in other language, in other German accents, or Germans, you can say, for instance, they write it with this. They don't have this, but they use two S's instead. In Switzerland, for instance. Außen is the same. You speak it like two S's, but you have this old German letter. Actually, it's called SZ. Now, I must tell you something. This is Straße. You have that. In Switzerland, they call it Straße with double S. Here, they write it with the SZ. But I want to explain that to you. Wait a minute. Okay. So maybe it's actually a little bit to know about why is it called SZ? In old German, we wrote, the old Germans, my mother still, when she went to school, she learned the old German writing, handwriting, and that was totally different. Most children, nobody, I can read it because I studied mathematics once and we needed these letters, these old German letters, but it's out. Actually, it's forgotten. Only people in history or in old documents, you find that. For instance, the A is written A like that. So you like an O, and then they write and they have that A. This is the way the hand in handwriting. B was actually the same, etc. And they had the letter, that's why it's called SZ. S, you know, Z is nowadays this. Yeah? And an S is this. But this letter is called SZ because the old S was written like this, like a big one. S, that was spoken S. And the Z was written like this. Z. S, Z. And then you put these two together, you have this letter here. Huh? S, Z. You know, sometimes they wrote it like that. So you have both letters, S and Z, combined. Huh? Or they would write it like that. Huh? So SZ is an old letter, but it is still used. I don't know why it is still in the German language, in the writing SZ, but you should know about it. Huh? So in case you don't know, in case you forgot about it, you just can use it with a double S. You can substitute it by double S. So we have, sometimes we have Straße. Huh? Here, for instance, Eichenstraße. Sometimes you write it like this with an SZ, and sometimes you write it with a double S. So it doesn't matter really. But it's important, of course, when you learn to know it. So was haben wir gemacht? Also, wir haben das Problem. Du hast, wir hatten jetzt das Alphabet. Ach, Emanuel sollte nochmal, ja. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Sag's mal auf. Yeah, no, you can look at the letters, but you must pronounce them correctly.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, I, J, K, R, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, V, X, Y,
Z. Z. Und da haben wir das alte, this is the old Z, and that's the modern Z. S, old S, modern S.
The S with the slash is the
modern. Ja, ja, ja. So, Straße. Sag, kannst du das Alphabet?
A, B, C, D.
Nee, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P.
A, B, C.
C, C, C,
C,
C.
D.
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 D. Not D, D.
D.
D. Weiter?
D. F.
Ja.
G. H. I.
E. E, 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 I. E. Richtig. Hey, komm hier.
Hey. J.
Nee, F hast du vergessen. You forgot F. E, F.
E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, L, S. T.
Nee, T ist macht den Sinn vielleicht T.
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 U. V. B. S.
Nee, X ist Englisch.
X. Like
X.
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 X. Y.
Y.
Z.
Z. Ja, gut, gut. I think you did a good job here. Jetzt, dann haben wir, we have these two these three letters that we had here, and we want to practice that a little. What you have to do really is the pronunciation of a language is very important so that people understand you. Let's say a sentence. Let's see if you understand it. You can copy it. Wir is clear what wir mean, no? Bedeutet, means? Wir, here we have an Ü in it. Wir müssen Wir müssen üben. You know what üben means?
No.
Wir müssen, you have here two Ü's, müssen üben. And we combine this now, the pronunciation of the Ü letter, with the conjugation of the verb. But wir müssen üben, do you understand what it means? Wir, versteht ihr, ne? Wir müssen
üben.
Müssen viel üben. Wir müssen viel üben. We must üben. Üben. What does üben mean?
Üben.
Practice. Put something into practice. Üben. And üben is a good word to ich. We say ich. Now let's revise the endings for the verb. I practice. We just you have the pronouns. The pronouns you know. Ich. What comes after ich?
Ich.
Nee, you.
Bin. Du.
Du. Richtig, Maria. Du. Und dann haben wir, we have the third person, we have three pronouns. Er.
Sie.
She is sie. And es. That's one. Actually, they have the same form, so you put them on one line. Ich, du, er, sie, es. Plural, that's all singular. Singular means one person. Ich, one person. Du, eine Person. One person. Er, one person. Sie, eine Person. One person. Es, one person. One thing. Person or thing. That's why it's called singular. Singular, you know the germ singular also. The same word in English. Singular. Single, you know, one. A person is single or married or whatever, you have that, singular. And now here we have, what when you are more than one person, what do you call that?
Plural.
Plural, richtig, ja, plural.
Auf Deutsch?
Plural, ja, auf Deutsch und in English is the same. Plural, plural, plural. Singular, plural. Actually, big S, we must put here a big S. Singular, because these are nouns. Nouns are written with big letters in front. So, Plural. Welchen Plural ist?
Wir.
Hier haben wir wir, klar. Wir, we. Wir, wir, wir.
Wir.
And you, richtig, wer sagt es? Ihr, richtig, ihr. For instance, I can say, ihr lernt Deutsch. Ihr, you. I exclude myself from that, but just speak about you, ihr. Und they, over there, there's another group in the other room, and you say they, und im Deutschen heißen die dann?
Sie.
Sie lernen auch Deutsch. Sie, ja. Sie. This is at the same time a plural word, or, you know it already, the very polite word, with a capital S, Sie. Wie heißen Sie? It is not plural. It is meant to be a singular, but we use the plural form for politeness. That's the strange thing. So, jetzt machen wir aber üben, dieses Wort hier, das üben. Here, you must remember now the endings of the verb. And to speak that word, you have two problems. I thought about it when I, you know, prepared. I thought a little, what should I do with you? So you have the ü in it. Ü, richtig, gut. Kannst du sagen, gut, ü. Und jetzt haben wir das ü in it. Üben, practice, to practice. Und wir müssen die endings of the German, you know, the conjugation, the different endings. Do you remember which ending do we take for ich, Emanuel? Welche in the present tense? Welche ist?
N-E or E?
Nee, ich is?
Ich.
What ending? What's the last letter of the verb then? Richtig, aber in Deutsch? Im Deutsch? Richtig, ja. Ich, am Ende, ich spreche. Ich lerne. Ich gehe, I go. Ich schreibe, ich gehe, ich laufe. It's always eh. Zeichne, weiß ich was. Und dann ist das, ja, und dann, welches nehmen wir, welches ist die, so we have here an E, right? Du, du,
S-T.
Richtig, S-T am Ende. Dann haben wir er, sie, es. Welches, Maria? Welchen Buchstaben? Which letter do we take at the end then? Er, sie, es, he, she, it. Nee. Ja, doch, richtig. T. Ja, 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 klar. T. 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 Und hier, wir.
E. E.
E. N. Richtig. E. N. Hier.
S. T.
T. Wieder dasselbe wie hier. Ist confusing. Und hier, sie.
E. N.
E. Wieder E. N. Actually, that's easy. But it's easy, but confusing. For me, it would be confusing. If I had to learn German, I would give it up. It's so confusing, really. So, und jetzt haben wir eine Übung, an exercise, practice, exercise. Ich, wie heißt das Wort? I practice. Ich, sag's mal.
Ich übe.
Na, wie? Üben. Nee, na, E am Ende. Ein E hier. Hier.
Ich muss.
Lass ihn mal sagen.
Ich muss.
Nee, wir nehmen nur I practice. No müssen. Müssen ist in addition. We do that later.
Ich muss.
That's irregular. That's why we don't take it. We take it later. Irregular things come later. We don't. We want to learn the regular things. Ich. I practice.
Ich übene.
What's the ending of the word?
I.
Ja, also sag mal nochmal, say it again. Ich.
Übe.
Ist kurzes E. Ich übe. Hier, ja. So. That's all. Ich übe, I practice. Ich übe Deutsch, können wir auch sagen. Deutsch. I practice German. Ich übe Deutsch. Jetzt, Emanuel, sag du mal du.
Ich, du. Du bist.
Nee.
Du bist.
Nee. Üben ist falsch. Hier ist die Endung.
Du bist. Du bist.
It's very difficult to speak. Nee, here's the ending. That's the ending of the word.
Ja, ja.
So it must be.
Du bist.
Du?
Du bist.
Nee, ja. The funny thing is, that's interesting, very interesting. What you're doing now is you're using old German. For instance, Martin Luther, when he translated the Bible into German, he would say it like you, because he said, übest. He would put an E in here and say,
yeah.
But in modern German, you don't put an E in it anymore. It's old German. Because it, of course, you automatically put an E, an Ü best, because it speaks more easily. It's spoken more easily, actually. Ü best. That is Martin Luther's German, but it's 500 years old. but the funny thing is, you did it automatically, because you just wanted to make it a little easier, and that's what they have. And nowadays, it's more difficult, because they dropped the E as A here drinne. Du übst. And that's what really difficult is, because you have the B and an S and a T together.
You take the stem.
Yeah.
The stem, and then you add this.
Yeah, yeah. Then it's the same here. You would put in the old German, you put an E in it, an A. Du übst. Martin Luther würde das so sagen. Aber du übst. And that is difficult. See, Maria. Maria says, oh, I cannot say it. Du übst Deutsch. Du übst Deutsch.
Du übst.
Ja, du übst Deutsch. Du übst. Übst. And the funny, another thing is, we don't speak the B, you write a B, von üben, but you speak it like a P. Du übst. It's like, a little bit like P. Du übst Deutsch. You are practicing German. You are learning German. Übst. And you have the Ü letter in it. See, this is really difficult. You have the letter Ü, which is difficult for you. Then we speak this B like a P. And then you have st. And you think nobody can hear that. Übst. Du übst Deutsch.
Du übst.
Maria, sag's mal. Du übst Deutsch.
Du übst.
Übst.
Du
übst. Psst. Psst, 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 psst. Ja. Übst Deutsch. This, this is only an exercise in pronunciation and trying to speak to get your mouth used to the German sounds. Huh? And that's why we must do that from time to time, trying to get your mouth to practice that. Du übst Deutsch, sag mal.
Du übst Deutsch.
The Ü, the problem is not that you have the last letters correct, but the Ü. Ü, ja. Übst, übst.
Du bist.
Du übst.
Du.
Ist richtig, ja, ja, you're getting closer, getting closer.
Du übst.
Ja, gut, ist okay, Deutsch. Du übst Deutsch. You're practicing German.
Du bist Deutsch.
Übst Deutsch ist Luther, German. But it's okay, we can understand it. But then we'd say, oh, is that very old German? But it's okay, it's okay. But it's German, after all. Huh? Du übst Deutsch. Sag mal, du übst Deutsch. Übst du auch Deutsch?
Du
übst.
Übst.
Übst, ja.
Übst Deutsch.
Oh, und Emanuel?
Du übst Deutsch.
Ja, dein Ü ist ja, I'm doing this because of the Ü. He is practicing German. Sie, es. Can you construct this? It's a little bit like mathematics. You just think. Yeah.
U.
Nicht U. U ist U, but Ü ist Ü.
So,
Ü. Richtig, ja. You hardly hear this, huh? Can you notice that? Übt. Übt. Here, we write it. Übt.
Übt.
He practices German. Übt Deutsch. Sag nochmal, jetzt. Try to get. Yeah, yeah. Even if you speak a little.
Übt.
Übt Deutsch.
Übt
Deutsch. Gut, ja, ist gut. Gut, das ist gut. Everybody will understand you. Übt auch Deutsch.
Übt
sie. Richtig, gut. Übt. Sie übt auch Deutsch. Sie. She is also practicing German. Sie übt.
Übt.
Übt, ja, ja. Übt Deutsch. Sie übt, übt Deutsch. When you hear that, it's hardly, nobody can really make something out, but it is. He übt, übt, sie übt, es übt. Wir, Emanuel, wie geht das hier mit dem Üb?
Üben.
Richtig, üben, ja. Aber üben. Wir üben Deutsch. Sag's mal, Emanuel.
Wir üben
Deutsch. Deutsch, richtig. Und weiter, wie geht das dann weiter, sag du?
Übt.
Auch dasselbe, it's the same. Same as here. Ihr übt, you practice German. Ihr, plural. I speak about you and I say, ihr übt jetzt Deutsch. You are now practicing German. The pronunciation of some difficult letters and a little bit of grammar mixed with grammar. Ihr übt Deutsch. Sie That's like the infinitive. The infinitive is the basic form. Sag mal. Mhm. Richtig. Wie sagt man den ganzen Satz? Say a whole sentence. You can say a sentence now. Den ganzen Satz. They are practicing German. Sag mal. Deutsch.
Sie üben Deutsch.
Richtig. Sie üben auch Deutsch. They are also practicing German. Üben, that's easy. But the problem is, of course, the Ü, but it's correct. Üben in one word. Sie üben Deutsch. Ich übe. Now let's speak it. It's a pronunciation. As I said, it's a practice in pronunciation. Wir üben die Aussprache. Pronunciation is Sprache, language. Aussprache, how to speak out something, how to pronounce something. The English word is pronounce. Aussprache. Aussprache. Kommen Sie rein, Frau Erika. Wie geht es? Das ist schön. Was hörst du? Oh, kommt noch jemand? Sehr gut. Wir haben geübt. Wir haben.
Sie,
hallo, du bist hier.
Sie haben getan. Okay,
das ist jetzt, ja.
Gut. Aber letzte Woche kommst du, ne?
Hast du die gebracht?
Ja, beide.
Gut.
Ich geführt, ja. Okay, dann
bis nächste Woche. Ja, bis nächste Woche, ja. Last week. I was not here. And do you know where I was? Wisst ihr, wo ich war?
Yes.
No.
Wo war ich? Ich buchstabiere es. Ich buchstabiere es für euch. Ja? Ich war in E. Write it down. So I want to see if you know your alphabet.
Okay.
Ich war. Ich war. This is another thing we do next time, because the irregular verb, ich bin, du bist, er ist, wir sind, ihr seid, sie sind und so weiter. Aber ich war is the past tense. I was. Yeah? War. W-A-R. Ich war. Last week. You don't have to write that. But wait a minute, I have, ich war letzte Woche, it's easy to understand for you, when you know English, as I told you, you can learn German quite well. Ich war, W-A-R, war ist, wird mit geschrieben, here you have something, that's my last one actually, for somebody need a pen, here have you, I have some pens. You can keep them. I bought them once. You have something? You are rich.
I'm not.
You want? Braucht einer noch ein Stift? You can have it. Emanuel hat auch einen. Ja, gut. So, also, ich war. Last week, letzte Woche, but you don't have to write that. Ich war in, ist wie Englisch. Ich war nicht in Berlin. Ich war nicht. Come on. Now we are practicing a little bit understanding. Try. We practice the pronunciation, Aussprache. Ich war nicht in Berlin. Ich war in. And now I will spell you the word where I was. Ich war. Letzte Woche, last week, ich war in Erika schreiben. L habt ihr, ja? L, nochmal, I-R-L-A. All the letters that you confuse with the English alphabet.
A,
is my, I finish it now. N, she gives up. D. Nochmal von vorn, from the beginning. Ich war in. I. Somebody come to the, here, you come to the board. Yeah, come on, you do on the board. Yeah, let's see if you get it right. Nochmal. Hier, schreib mal hier unten. Ich war in. I.
Ich war.
Ja, richtig. W-A-R. Richtig. In.
In.
Genau. I.
I.
Ja, ja.
Okay.
I. Yeah, yeah, don't say English. That's a, because we get confused. I and I und so, ja. Ich war in I, richtig. R.
R.
L.
L.
L, ja. A.
A.
A. N.
N.
D.
D.
Ist das richtig? Warte, 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 warte. Hier, ja, okay. Warte mal. Nee, 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 nein, 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 nein. Warte mal, hier, hier. Das ist mein Souvenir aus
Ireland.
Ja, mein Souvenir. Ich war in. But you see, the English again is different. What's different with the German? Ja, hier, you have, hier, da gibt es ein E. Irland. And we, in German we drop the E. Irland. Irland. Is the letter we have to practice. Irland. 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 Ich war letzte Woche in Irland. It's a sentence you can understand. Last week I was in Ireland. Letzte Woche war ich in Irland.
Irland. Correct pronunciation, not right.
Irland. Irland. English, Ireland. Irland. Okay, aber ich war in Irland und dort war ich in der Hauptstadt. Wie heißt die Hauptstadt von Irland? Ja, wie heißt die Hauptstadt von Irland?
Dublin.
Kannst du das buchstabieren? Buchstabieren. Die Hauptstadt. Hauptstadt. Berlin ist die Hauptstadt von Deutschland. Was ist die Hauptstadt von Irland? Von Irland. Ja, kannst du das buchstabieren? Nee, sag's mal, ich schreib. Du bist mein Lehrer, you are my teacher now. Oh, we put it here. Nee, die gibt's nicht im Deutschen. Deutsches Alphabet. Switch over to the German alphabet.
D.
Ja, D, richtig.
U.
O.
B.
Wie?
B.
B, ja.
L.
Richtig.
I.
Nee.
I.
Ah ja, doch, auf Deutsch, ja, doch, richtig. Ja, ja. I, L. Richtig, Deutsch, N, ja. Ja, das ist okay. Aber Irland ist schwer, ne? I, R, L, A, N, D. I, is this confusion with the English alphabet is very quickly happens there. Ich war in Irland. Wo ich war letzten Sonntag. Mit dem Flugzeug nach Irland bin ich geflogen. 5 Tage in Irland, in Dublin. Fünf Tage war ich dort. Ja, und hier haben wir 5 Tage war ich in Dublin. Ja, wo wart ihr, Erika? Wo wart ihr? Ihr wart auch nicht hier. Wir hatten letzten Sonntag keinen Unterricht hier, kein Deutsch. Kein Deutsch, letztes Mal. Wo wart ihr? Where were you? Last Sunday. Du warst zu Hause? Ich war zu Hause. Now we do it. We always do a little bit of this and that, you know, like something like you form sentences. Easy sentence. Ich war zu Hause.
Hey.
Ich, I was at home. Ich war zu Hause. Okay, du warst zu Hause. Ich war am Sonntag zu Hause. Am Sonntag? 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 Sonntag?
Sonntag?
Richtig, Sonntag. Du warst du auch zu Hause?
Bitte?
Warst du auch zu Hause?
Ich war Abon.
Abon.
Wo war er? Wo war er?
Music.
Music.
Wo?
Ich
war.
War.
War. Ich war. I was.
Ich war Abon Land.
Weiß nicht, was verstehe ich nicht.
Music.
Musik. Musik. Ihr hattet Musik.
Yeah. Musik.
Musik.
Yeah.
Habt ihr gesungen?
Da, 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 da.
Okay, gut, 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 gut. Ja. Wie heißt du? Erika, Emanuel, weißt du, wie er heißt?
Es?
Er.
Ihr?
Ihr, ne? Er, 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 er.
Ja. Ihr Name, APJ.
Er heißt wie?
Bitte?
Wow. Du kannst doch mal sagen, ich weiß nicht.
Ich weiß nicht.
Du weißt nicht, wie er heißt.
Ja.
Maria, weißt du, wie er heißt? Weißt du, do you know? Weißt du, wie er heißt? What's his name? Du, ich weiß nicht. Das ist gutes Deutsch. Das ist perfekt, ja? Ich weiß nicht. Weißt du, wie er heißt? Nein? Nein, nein. Dann musst du sagen.
Sagen.
Ich weiß auch nicht. Neither do I know.
Ich weiß nicht.
Auch. Also. Ja, ich weiß auch nicht. Ich weiß auch nicht. Weißt du, wie er heißt?
Ich.
Ich weiß nicht.
Weißt du auch nicht? Du weißt auch nicht, wie er heißt. Nein, weißt du, wie er heißt? Weißt du, wie er heißt? Ich weiß auch nicht. Gut, gut gesagt. Ja, weiß auch nicht. Erika, weißt du, wie er heißt?
Ich weiß auch nicht.
Oh, ho, ho, ho. Glaubst du wirklich, ja? Weißt du, wie er heißt?
Ja. Das ist.
Er heißt. Ja, wie heißt der?
Ja, das ist APJ.
Wie buchstabierst du das?
Stabil?
Ja, wie heißt der? A.
P.
P.
P. I. A.
A und A oder R?
H.
H.
G.
No.
G.
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 Y.
Y oder J?
Y.
Y.
I.
Wie spricht man das? How do you speak that? Say your name yourself. Apiagai. Isn't there a short form for it?
Yeah.
Apia.
Yeah.
Apiat.
Yeah.
That is good.
A little bit more simple.
Apia. Apia, this is good. The Apia. So you have missed a lot of alphabet and things. You will catch up. Yeah. Good. You ask her to teach you.
No problem.
Oh, gut. Jetzt haben wir. Wir müssen üben. Wir müssen. Also, let's say together. Ich übe.
Ich übe.
Nee, I didn't like that. Übe. Ich übe Deutsch. Nochmal.
Ich übe Deutsch.
That sounds pretty good now, yeah. Du übst auch Deutsch.
Du übst auch Deutsch.
Auch. Auch Deutsch. Er übt Deutsch.
Er übt Deutsch.
Sie übt auch Deutsch.
Sie übt auch Deutsch.
S, we drop the S. S is usually not used, but it, for things. Wir üben Deutsch.
Wir üben Deutsch.
Ihr übt auch Deutsch.
Ihr übt auch Deutsch.
That sounds, yeah. Sie üben Deutsch.
Sie üben Deutsch.
Not so much üben, but üben. But it's getting much better. I must make you a compliment. It's really much better. So from time to time. What else did we want to do now? Did you have some homework, actually?
Yeah. It was reading.
Reading? Yeah. Mm-hmm. This... Sprechen. Ah, das, ja, jetzt weiß ich, ja. Deutsche Welle, ja, guten Tag. Moment. Wo haben wir das? Audiotrainer. Okay, I wanted to check if you have learned. Okay, yeah, if anybody still needs, ich habe noch ein paar. Wollen wir mal gucken. Deutsch. Moment. Hier, hat noch jemand das Blatt nicht?
Danke.
Ja, gerne. Bitte sehr. Das hast du, okay. Hast du das? Hast es. Ja, gut. Emanuel? Er hat auch keins, nein. Du hast es, okay. I just want to give you some thing that we will do in the future. This is a regular verb, a verb that is, you don't change when you change it into the different forms. But there are many verbs in German that change. Ich, for instance, ich habe, have, haben, ich habe, and then it changes, du hast, you have, er hat, wir haben, ihr habt, sie haben. That the changes in the middle of it. Sometimes the verb changes in the second form, and so on. But this is regular here. It's just where you add these endings here, and then it's okay. But some others change in the middle of the verb. And that's something we will take much later. Ich habe das. I have this. Deutsche Welle. Wie heißt, I can check your homework if you've done your homework. Wie heißt der Großvater? Rubbish. I wanted to have the German word for grandfather.
Oh. Großvater.
Und Grandmother. You did the right thing, because now we are coming to a point in the German language that you will find most terrible. Because you have to learn, as I told you at the beginning in the first lesson, for every word, every noun, you have to remember and learn the gender. How many genders do we have in German?
Three.
Yeah, in German we have three genders. Er, here we have it. Er, sie, es. Now, er is what? Masculine. He, yeah. She, sie, feminine. And es is? Neutral, yeah, neuter, they call that in grammar, neuter. And now, from now on, we will have to learn, you will really try to memorize the gender of every German word, because it is not logical, I told you. In this case, it is actually logical, because you have grandmother, what logical article would you take? Ja, die, ne? Die Großmutter. Der Großvater is masculine. That's easy. Aber he and she, er und sie. That's something you know already. The father is another. It's easy because persons usually take he or she, er oder sie. Er und sie, male and female. Although nowadays the Americans, and they have found out there are about 60 different genders. They are stupid. This is really, I find that so stupid. But anyway, Vater is der Vater. Mutter?
Die Mutter.
Kind Maria. Kind is neutral. Normally, when we see a child, we will see a little child, we don't know, is it a boy or a girl? So we have a neuter. Some, it can be both. So es, nicht? Es, das Kind. Der Mutter, der Vater, die Mutter, er und sie, das Kind. There's, then we have der Sohn, the son. Take the next one, the daughter. It's easy, also remember, daughter is female, normally. Die, do you have it in front? Die Tochter. Gut, die Tochter. Ja, hast du eine Tochter?
Nein.
Hast keine Tochter? Ich habe keine Tochter. I have no daughter. You can make German sentences now. Huh? It's pretty good. Hast du einen Sohn? Ich habe einen Sohn. Wie heißt der Sohn?
Ich habe...
Nee, ja gut, ich habe einen Sohn, aber wie heißt dein Sohn? Wie heißt dein Sohn?
Ja, wie heißt?
You can't answer with ja, but what's his name? You have a son, what's his name? Wie heißt der Sohn?
Kelvin.
Kevin or Kelvin?
Kelvin.
Ja, gut, mein Sohn heißt Kelvin.
Mein Sohn heißt Kelvin.
Heißt, yeah, it's good, just repeat it. Even sometimes you must repeat sentences or words that you don't even know. Children do that. Children repeat some things like that, because they want to practice German. Sie müssen üben, 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 sie üben, Flora, Kinder, üben, ja, immer üben. Die, was haben wir noch? Weiter, the brother.
Bruder.
Try to do it by memory, not looking at the paper. You can look at the paper, because you got it just now. The others was your homework, you know. Erika, die Schwester. I said it in English. Also frage ich dich, the uncle.
Der Onkel.
Der Onkel is masculine. It's a man usually. The aunt, Emmanuel.
Die Tante,
richtig. Und dann haben wir er und sie, he and she. And then we have three sentences at the bottom. We are a family, Maria. Lies mal vor.
Wir sind eine Familie.
Wir sind eine Familie. We are a big family. Wir sind eine Familie. Richtig. The family is not small. Der nächste. Lies mal vor. The next sentence.
Die Familie ist nicht klein.
Ja, ist not small, ne? Ist nicht klein, haben wir auf Englisch da. And das große, Erika, your family is big. Ja? Meine Familie ist, Ofuso Familie ist groß, ganz groß. Stimmt, ja? Is that right? Stimmt, ne? Wie viel sind in der Ofuso Familie? 20, 100 Leute, ja? Also das, here we see the gender thing. That is the big problem to learn. For instance, what do you think? Is this, is it male, female, neuter? An idea. Just to give you an idea, this. And we have a good exercise also. Here, I will write the word for this thing here. Im Deutsch sagen wir, schön für ein Umlaut.
Music.
Nee, nobody will understand you if you make it shorter.
Music.
Yeah, Mutze is something that we don't understand. Well, you don't speak the ü correctly. Sometimes. Nee, here. Yeah. And the gender, what do you think? Is it der, die, das? We have these three. Okay. Der, die, das.
Das.
Das Mütze? Nee. Der Mütze? Nein. See, it's all guess. How can you... Yeah, it is female. Die, it's actually die. Huh? It is female. How do we know that something is female in this case? It is not logical. But how do we kind of learn this? As how do German children learn this? Say, the German children say, du hast, you have, der Mütze ist groß, oder klein. Huh? Your children will say that. And then what will mother or father say? Der Mütze ist groß. Der Mütze ist schön. She will say that, a child will say that. What will parents say? Nicht der Mütze, die Mütze. They will correct the children. And that's the way they learn the gender of all things in German. Because other people just correct them when they make a mistake, or they don't have to correct them because it's the right gender. Die Mütze. This is a female thing. Huh? What else do I have here? This thing. Kreide. Kreide. Chalk. Yeah, Kreide. Make a guess. Erika? Die Kreide. Correct. You hit the jackpot. Die Kreide. Das ist die Kreide. Die Kreide. Do I have something like that? Yeah, this thing here. Das Stuhl. Stuhl. In English you have the word stool, but it, you know, chair. Different. Chair. Chair. Okay. Of Stuhl. What do you think? Der, yeah. Die, das. Which sounds good to you? Huh? Das? Nee.
Die.
Falsch. Yeah. Ihr bleibt nur noch eins. You tried one, and you say, yeah. der Stuhl. It's masculine. I don't see where it is masculine, yeah. But it is not logical in German, but it is der Stuhl. And so if you say die Stuhl, das Stuhl, I will correct you, or your father will correct your mother, or your friends will correct you, and then you will remember it. German is a thing to remember, you know, the different. But I want to, it's not so bad. If you make a mistake, don't worry. Even Germans make mistakes about the gender, the different gender. You say, die Stuhl ist neu. Neu, Maria, was heißt neu? Neu, kennst du das Wort neu?
New.
The opposite of neu ist alt.
Neu
und alt. New and old. Der Stuhl, you can make sentences. Der Stuhl ist neu.
Meine Handy ist alt.
Dein Handy ist alt. Alt, ja.
Der Stuhl.
Stuhl, I write you. See, there's another interesting thing you want to now know. How is this word written? Because sometimes words are written in a funny way. Stuhl, I write you. Stuhl. This H in it, der Stuhl. So you have to learn the gender of that thing, der, masculine. Stuhl, S-T-U-H-L. The ha is not spoken, the H is not spoken. It is just, in many words, this H has the function that it makes the previous vowel longer. Stuhl, not Stuhl, because there's the word Stulle. For instance, I just give you a D. Stulle is the slice of bread. See, it's similar, but there's no H in it, so it's a short U. And it's Stulle. Stulle is actually slang, a little slangish in Berlin. And it is the slice of bread. When that you take when you go to school, you kind of make a sandwich with Stulle or something. And it is, to remember, D. That's a funny thing. It's again E, D, a different gender. And now I think I have given, I want to give you nochmal. Großvater, there is some logic in that. Grandfather is der Großvater. Grandmother, die. You know, when you know it's people and so on. Onkel, Tante, der Onkel, die Tante. We had der Sohn, the son, die Tochter, the daughter. There it's clear that it's der oder die. But with many things, you don't know it. You have to remember it. It's learning German is a question of, let's say,
question of memory, having a good memory, some good memory. I have here something for you to learn for the next time. Now, that will give you some headaches. I bet. It's Hausaufgabe. To remember, I will ask you next time. And you have der, die, das things here. And a whole list, but we want to clarify first. First, we clarify what they mean. There are some hard words. Now we go into learning words, the most important grammar. So, it's the genus or the gender, masculine, feminine, oder neutrum. Masculine, der, die, oder das. Ergänzen Sie den bestimmten Artikel. Now, that's something that you can do, but first of all, let's be clear. On the left side, you have a whole column with D, with female words. But what do these female words mean? And that's why you need a pen and you want to write the translation if you don't understand. Die Frau. That's easy, huh? Aber Übung. Here, we had this today. Here, die Übung. Üben, üben. Die Übung is a noun. This is a verb, what you do. Und Übung is die Übung. Try to remember that. Die Übung, the exercise. The exercise. Zeitung. Weiß einer das? Does somebody know?
Time.
Zeitung. Yeah, Zeit. There's the word Zeit in it. Time is in it. But it is actually what is happening at the time. And that's what is written down in der Zeitung. Die Zeitung? Who knows it? Newspaper.
Oh.
Uh-huh. Newspaper. You write the translation if you can try to memorize it, but also if you can write die Zeitung, the newspaper, just on top of it or below it or somehow. Werbung. Now the words are getting more difficult, but it gives you an idea. Werbung. Werbung is when you switch on the TV or the radio and they say, buy Coca-Cola. Yeah, advertising. Werbung. Die Werbung is feminine, female. Dann Musik, you know that, with some fantasies, somewhere. You can say Musik. Musik, you don't have to translate that, but you'll have to remember that it is female. Music is female. Die Musik. Die Musik. Politik is also a word that you know when you know English. Huh? Politics, politics. Die Politik. It's all female words here. Operation, the English is operation. Operation, the pronunciation is a little different. Die Operation. Dann haben wir die Situation. These are all words that are very similar to English. Situation. But we must speak it. Situation. Situation.
Friendship.
Ja, Freundschaft, die Freundschaft. Friendship, richtig. Botschaft, das nächste. Die Botschaft ist, what is eine Botschaft? It's used a lot in church also. Die Botschaft von Gott. The message of God is Jesus Christ, for instance. Die Botschaft. Botschaft, message. Die Botschaft. Now, I told you that in the second or third lesson, when we have a word and we add I-N, E-N am Ende, what is the effect?
Female.
It makes it female. Huh? It is now der Freund, it's masculine, the friend, the boyfriend or whatever, die Freundin. Whenever you have a word where in is at the end, means the female, then you have, of course, to take die, die Freundin, Ne, die Freundin. The friend, the girlfriend or the female friend. Does somebody know the next word? Krankheit? Die Krankheit? Hospital? It's got something to do with the hospital, yeah. What it is? Sickness. The sickness or illness, whatever, two words. Yeah, illness or sickness. Die Krankheit. Ja, die Krankheit. Ist im Krankenhaus? You are normalerweise Krankenhaus, Krankheit, Krankenhaus. Gesundheit is the opposite, and that is then the opposite of sickness is
health.
Gesundheit. Gesundheit. When somebody sneezes, we say Gesundheit. You know it in English, even the Americans say Gesundheit sometimes, but Gesundheit. They use the German word. Bless you in British. Yeah? Gesundheit. Health, actually. Health. Und was haben wir dann? Palme. Palme. Palm tree. So lots of words are actually very similar to English, you can tell. And now we have to kind of drill you just for when we hear it, we know this is the right article or it's not the right article. So let's all say together, we have something like 10 minutes. That's good for every column here. Also, let's speak together. And you remember what they mean. So you learn the words, what they mean, and you learn that they are female words, and you learn to pronounce them correctly, hopefully. Also, machen wir mal. Let's say together. Die Frau.
Die Frau.
Die Übung.
Die Übung.
Die Zeitung.
Die Zeitung.
Die Werbung.
Die Werbung.
Nochmal, again. Die Werbung.
Die Werbung.
Commercials, ne? Die Musik.
Die Musik.
Die Politik.
Die Politik.
Die Operation.
Die Operation.
Nochmal, die Operation.
Die Operation.
Okay. Die Situation.
Die Situation.
Die Freundschaft.
Die Freundschaft.
Die Botschaft.
Die Botschaft.
Die Freundin.
Die Freundin.
Die Krankheit.
Die Krankheit.
Die Gesundheit.
Die Palme.
Ja, yeah, gut. Also, so, the thing is, you hear that, and sometimes you hear somebody use a wrong article, a wrong gender. Then somehow your brain tells you, automatically, you have never heard that. Somebody says, der Gesundheit. You say, it sounds odd. Because you know it's die Gesundheit. Somehow you've heard it, and now when we speak it together, you have heard it. And your brain is just like a computer. It programs this in a way, hopefully. Sometimes you forget. So let's take the next column. Let's speak together. It's all der, natürlich. It's male. Der Mann, together. Der Mann, der Computer.
Der
Fernseher.
Der Fernseher.
Der Apparat.
Der
Automat. We will speak about the meaning of the words afterwards. Just repeat now, so you get the pronunciation. The correct pronunciation is also very important. Also, der Apparat.
Der Apparat.
Der Automat.
Der Automat.
Der Projektor.
Der Projektor.
Der Motor.
Der
Apfel.
Der Apfel.
Der Pinsel.
Der Pinsel.
Der Frühling.
Der Frühling.
Der Patient.
Der Patient.
Der Honig.
Der Honig.
Der Teppich.
Der Teppich.
Der Mensch.
Mensch.
Wow. So now you have questions. What have you found out some meanings yet?
Apfel, I know it's apple.
Ja, der Apfel ist.
Ja,
let's. Okay, let's go for. Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Welches?
Honig.
Honig. See, funny thing is, for instance, the G at the end here is spoken like sh, like the next word Teppich. That's the end is sh at the end. Teppich. Ch. Is it carpet? Und Honig, it's a G, and it's still also spoken like a CH. So these are little problems. Let's go down from the top. Mann, ist klar, der Mann, the man, der Computer, clear. Der Fernseher ist?
Fernseher.
Huh?
Television.
Television set, yes, TV set. Der Fernseher. It's actually a funny meaning of the German word is somebody looking far away. With your television set, you can look far away into other countries. Fern, far. Sehen, look. Look far. Oh, Fernsehen.